हेलो के सदावत हुज अपीयरिंग इन द आंध्र प्रदेश हाई कोर्ट रोहित्स मदर राधिका जी एंड फ्रेंड्स वी आर सेलिब्रेटिंग डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब अम्बेडकर्स 125 जयंती इन द मिड्स ऑफ अ मेन रोड. For me, this has not been anew. For last 35 years in social life, these situations have come, and let me tell you, we will overcome this situation. I faced worse situation than this. During the international conferences and basically United Nations, where a new social scheme theme was being formulated, elimination of all forms of discrimination. Some of us were interested in seeing the caste get included into it. When the caste got included, we had nearly after 176 countries, 136 countries behind us. And the government of India still kept on saying that we will not allow caste to be part of all forms of discrimination. I tried to break the ice by offering a cup of tea with the then Foreign Secretary, I will not name her, and she just refused. She said, I can't have a cup of coffee with you. I said, if you can't have my cup of coffee, I said, I'm ready to have your cup of coffee. Either this way or that way. She was fox-paused, didn't know what to do. She just walked away. In the afternoon, I again met her and I said, madam, I am an individual. I don't have the national strength. But let me tell you, in the last 7 years that I've been coming to United Nations for the same issue, I have nearly 780 international organizations, NGO, behind me on this issue. And out of 176 countries, I have 130 votes with me. You convey to Atal Bihari Vajpayee whether he wants to see India being defeated on the floor of the house. Then she said, I'm offering a cup of tea. I said, I don't want your cup of tea. Later on, when they saw that I have at least 126 votes, solid votes behind me, the government of India calls me and saying that can there be a truce? I said there can be a truce always, because I was interested in seeing that caste becomes one of the issue in elimination of all forms of discrimination. It has begun. The truce took place. We had a stalemate in the Durban conference. And after a year, when the General Assembly met in New York, caste was included in all forms of discrimination, and the General Assembly passed the resolution. In this country, people don't expect or accept anything as a face value. It has to be forced on them. But today, it's a very different situation. I addressed last time also when I came, and I'm going to repeat the same thing, that universities are going to become the center of chaos. Not just Hyderabad, but every university in the coming days is going to become a center of chaos. But this is a force which can rise. This is a force which can agitate. and this is a force who can be instigated. The process of instigation has begun. The instigation is not meaningless. The instigation is with a purpose and with an object. And the purpose and the object is, it may be BJP, it may be Jansan, it may be RSS. They don't have a history. And unless you have a historical background, you cannot survive. And therefore, one of the main purpose of pulling on issues like not changing the Vice Chancellor Appa Rao, even after some of the teachers have told me that a sad report has been sent by the intelligence department. That keeping Appa Rao in positions, how the universities is being affected, and then also the government sleeping on it. And therefore I said that their every action is a deliberate action, is a thoughtful action, and that every action which they want a reaction for that. And their reaction, as I've said, is for the only purpose that they want to create a chaos in this country. They have started increasing fees, as I've said, as everybody must be aware, with the IITs. They are now thinking of medical colleges. The University Grant Commission budget has been reduced by 35% this budget. That means the non-plan expenditure which the universities receive, they will be curtailed. And once they get curtailed, the universities will have no other option than to increase the fees. And once the fees increases, they are very sure that the students have no other alternative, because the parents can't bear those increased fees, they will have to be on the rolls. It's a sense, I may say so, that whichever ideology had a history in this country, that ideology and that history has failed. That is what they want to prove. And therefore, this is a time when I would say that we have to remain united. We have to agitate, but at the same time, we must not lose our coolness. We are not going to forget Rohit, let me tell you. I am informed by the Delhi students. That in Delhi, in the near future, in a month or so, what you used to say a parliament will be, a student's parliament will be called. And in that student parliament, Rohit Act and a committee will be formed. And that will begin, as the students are telling me, an all India level agitation. All universities will be covered up. Wherein the Rohit issue will be kept alive. And demands of this university, which have been forth put before the government, they are fulfilled. The rising has started. The only thing is that we will have to keep our cool. We'll have to strategize our own movement. And we will have to put it in such a way that the government start losing its grounds among the common man. Among students, they have become branded as being anti-students. We will now have to see that they get the same kind of branding within the families. It's a pressure that is going to work on this government. Some of us sent a message across that what is happening is not good. But the return messages that are coming is that you must understand what we are trying to do. I said, if you're trying to change the history, and if you're trying to change the system, don't forget, the systems are not built overnight. The confidence in the system is not built overnight. It takes time for a brand to get marketed. It takes time for the marketed brand to be believed by the common man. Today, whatever semblance of system that we have, it may be right or it may be wrong, but people believe in this system and they believe that we will get justice. And it is, I said, with this attitude that the students are agitating for justice of Rohit. We hope that this is 125th Dr. Babasaheb Jayanti, where the government has expressed that this Jayanti should be celebrated everywhere. In many of the places where the Prime Minister has gone for the attendance of Jayanti, place cards were placed. Would you give justice to Rohit? The system is getting effective. But as I have said, that they have their own goals. And they wish to achieve those goals. And while achieving those goals, make students the scapegoats. Therefore, I've been telling all students that we were also student leaders even in our period. We fought for ATKT and for other issues. We had a government who can say were themselves one of the agitators against the Britishers. But today you have a government who are not agitators, but they are beneficiaries of those agitators. Many of them do not have a history. For them, power has flown just because they are sons of somebody, daughters of somebody. They don't know anything of sacrifice, and they have never sacrificed. Let us say that this parliament, which will be conducted in Delhi, which I see a ray of hope where all representatives from universities are contacting and saying that we will attend that. If the universities take up this issue and if the students take up the issue, I am sure the government will one day have to bow before the students. I once again congratulate all of you for celebrating Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar Jayanti in the midst of the roads. Let the torch keep burning. We will keep this torch burning. With these few words, I thank you. And thank you for listening to me. Thank you.